millions who own one of them gas-drinking, piston-clanking, smoke-belching, air-polluting four-wheel buggies from Detroit City. Then pay attention, son. I'm about to sing your song. Listen. Joyce words all about that demon automobile, the metal monster with the polyglass wheels, the end result of the dream of Henry Ford. Well, now I got a car that's mine alone, to me and the finance company own, a ready-made pile of manufactured grief. And if I ain't out of gas in a pouring rain, I'm a fixing a flat in a hurricane. Once spent 3 days lost on a clover leaf. Well, now it ain't just the smoke and the traffic jam that makes me the bit of fool I am, but this four-wheel buggy is a dollarin' me to death. For gas and oils and fluids and grease and wires and tires and antifreeze and them accessories, well, honey, that's something else. Well, you can get stereo tape and a color TV, get a backseat bar and reclining seats, and just pay once a month like you do your rent. Well, I figured it up in over a period of time. This $4,000 car of mine cost $14,099. Well, now, Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, it seems your contribution to man, to say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done? Back up, son, I want to pick it now. Own one whole car and a half another, and I bet that half a car's a little tricky to drive, don't you? But the thing that amazes me, I guess, is the way we measure a man's success by the kind of an automobile he can afford to buy. Well, now it's red light, green light, traffic cop, right turn, no turn, must turn, stop. Get out the credit card, honey, we done plumb out of gas. Well, if all the cars were placed end to end, they'd reach to the moon and back again, and there'd probably be some idiot pull out the pass. Well, now, how long for the good old days without that carbon dioxide haze hanging over the roar of the interstate? Well, if the Lord that made the moon and the stars had a meant for me and you'd have cars, I'm sure we'd all be born with a parking space. Well, now, Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, it seemed your contribution to man, to say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Mr. Ford, what have you done? Come away with me, Lucille.